May I have your attention, please? Your Excellency, Raj Keshwar Prayag, President of the Republic of Mauritius, Madam Anita Prayag, Excellencies, distinguished guests. It gives me great pleasure to extend a warm welcome to you and your distinguished delegation on your first state visit to India. You are a long-standing friend of India and a strong advocate of closer ties between India and Mauritius. Excellency, our nations, bound by our historical ties, share a unique warmth and friendship built on the foundation of close bonds between our peoples. Present day, Mauritius is home to successful and progressive persons of Indian origin who have carved a niche for themselves in the country through their hard work and commitment to its progress. Since the days of Mahatma Gandhi, deep interest in Mauritius and the active involvement of Manilal Doctor in advocating social and political change in Mauritius in the early 90s, Mauritius has achieved much as an independent and a progressive nation. The father of modern Mauritius, Sir Shivsagar Ramgulam, had laid the foundation for democracy and the prosperity that your people enjoy today. India welcomes the socio-economic progress made by Mauritius in a short span of over four decades after its independence. Despite the downturn that impacted the global economy, Mauritius has shown remarkable resilience, and Mauritians have preserved to maintain their impressive economic growth and high standard of living. Excellency, the long-standing ties of cooperation between India and Mauritius have today evolved into a modern and vibrant partnership involving key sectors on both sides. This has been facilitated by our regular dialogue and intergovernmental initiatives operationalized through a framework of bilateral agreements, public and private sector joint ventures, and robust people-to-people contacts. The strong synergies and complementarities between our two economies indicate that there still remains a vast untapped potential, especially in the trade, investment, developmental, and infrastructural sectors. Excellency, we have a long history of cooperation in international fora. On issues of primary importance to us, including the fight against terrorism and our rightful claim to be a permanent seat at the United Nations Security Council, we appreciate the shared perception and support of Mauritius. We look forward to working with you for the long-term interests of both our countries, including on regional and global issues where we have similar concerns. I also take this opportunity to emphasize that the safety and security of our respective peoples should remain a high priority in our bilateral agenda. Peace and stability throughout the region of the Indian Ocean that washes our shores is an objective that we both share. We face the common challenge of maritime piracy that must be overcome by collective efforts of all the littoral states that are affected. We value the active support and involvement of the government of Mauritius in the Indian Ocean Rim Association for regional cooperation. Excellency, Mauritius was the venue for the 6th Overseas Pravasi Bharatiya Divas Convention held recently. I take this opportunity to thank your government and the people of Mauritius for welcoming this multidimensional event with enthusiasm. They have been active participants in the events and initiatives involving the 27 million strong Indian diaspora. We are particularly honored that you will be the chief guest at this year's Pravasi Bharatiya Divas convention in Kochi. Excellency, India's commitment to the progress and prosperity of Mauritius remains firm. We have taken several decisions on bilateral assistance and the economic package that we have discussed during our visit will no doubt take us forward towards our common objective. We are fully confident that during your presidency, the cherished ties, fraternal support, and cooperation between our two countries will be strengthened, and that our joint initiatives for the mutual benefit of our people will bring more progress and prosperity to them. With these words, Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, may I request you to join me in a toast to the health and personal well-being of Excellency the President of the Republic of Mauritius and Madam Anita Prayag, to the enduring tradition of close friendship and cooperation between India and Mauritius, and to the progress and prosperity of the friendly people of Republic of Mauritius.
Your Excellency, Sri Pranab Mukherjee, President of the Republic of India, Your Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. From the very moment we arrived, my delegation and I have been overwhelmed and deeply touched by the warmth of the hospitality that you have extended to us. I therefore wish to convey to you, Your Excellency, to the government and the people of India, my heartfelt thanks and appreciation for these high marks of goodwill. I bring to you the affectionate greetings and best wishes of the government and people of Mauritius. Founded on history, kinship, strong cultural links, and common ideals and values, the special and multidimensional relations between Mauritius and India are time-tested, not to say timeless. Our mutual beneficial relations have been buttressed by meaningful cooperation which covers almost every aspect of human endeavors. Our many shared interests and common vision allow our two countries not only to understand many critical issues on the regional and international agenda under the same light, but also to stand together and take a united front. In this respect, it is gratifying, Mr. President, to note that both our countries share the same determination of addressing development challenges, including extricating our peoples from poverty. I commend the government and people of India for the remarkable growth India has been sustaining over the last couple of years. And in Mauritius, we certainly take great pride from a rising India. Because the more India is prosperous economically, the better it augurs for our own economy, especially given our trade exchanges. India remains our main import market. Imports from India stood at some US $1.2 billion in the year 2011. India is also one of our main export markets. Mauritius exported approximately US $15.2 million worth of goods to India. Your Excellency, Mauritius had to overcome a number of external shocks to which we remain inherently vulnerable as a small island state. These include the dismantling of the multi-fiber agreement, the erosion of our preferential access to developed country markets, and rising fuel prices. We thus undertook fundamental reforms, some of which are ongoing. We focused on further opening up the economy and improving our competitiveness. We also laid down the foundations of new economic pillars, the aim of which was and still is to transform Mauritius into a center of excellence.
The government of Mauritius has now embarked upon an ambitious economic transformation program. The persisting crisis in the Eurozone, to which our economy is significantly linked, is, however, a major challenge to our resilience as a small island state. In a global, open and fiercely competitive economy environment where the strongest wins all, Mauritius will continue to rely on the esteemed support of friendly countries, of which India ranks amongst the highest. Indeed, the long-standing responsive and selfless support of India has been an important determinant of our growth performance, cultural vibrancy, and human empowerment. We in Mauritius very gratefully acknowledge and respect this generosity. This is a generosity that testifies to the special relations that our two countries entertain. Your Excellency, it is my deep conviction that our unique relationship inherently carries a rich potential for further deepening and widening the areas in which we have a common interest. In the Indian Ocean, for instance, which is considered as the ocean of this century, and where Mauritius has a vast continental shelf, we see a confluence of factors and interests compelling our two countries to increase our bilateral engagement. Similarly, in Africa, Mauritius stands ready to leverage its strategic links between Africa and Asia, its well-entrenched regional integration, and its business-conducive comparative environment to offer a propitious business-connecting platform between India with Africa. And I take this opportunity to invite the Indian business community to meaningfully consider this potential. Your Excellency, we are happily witnessing the increased weight of an ascending India in world affairs. India stands at the threshold of a new international order, with deeply rooted democratic credentials, its sustained economic growth, its continued willingness to share its experience and its leadership role in the Committee of Nations. India is contributing to global public goods. This is the new India which the world is looking to. This is the India that must have its rightful place in the Committee of Nations. I should also underscore the unflinching and unequivocal support of Mauritius to the long-standing and legitimate aspiration of India for a permanent seat in the UN Security Council. This, Mr. Your Excellency, reminds me of what the great Indian philosopher Sri Aurobindo stated, and I quote, "India has always existed for humanity and not for herself. And it is for humanity and not for herself that she must be great," unquote. Fully alive to the greatness of India, a fragment of which we have proudly inherited, I am confident, Your Excellency, that Mauritius and India will, with increasing synergy, lock themselves in a mutually beneficial partnership. Your Excellency, you are not a stranger to Mauritius, nor am I to India. This is in itself calls upon our respective privileged office to take the lead in further elevating our connections. With these words, I invite you all to raise a toast to the good health of Mr. President of the Republic of India and Mrs. Mukherjee, to the continued well-being and prosperity of our two nations and peoples, and to the everlasting friendship.